Did you know that over 4,000 square miles, or approximately 9% of Pennsylvania, is underlain by abandoned underground coal mines? When those mines collapse, mine subsidence damage can occur at the surface and impact homes, businesses, roads, utilities, and other features.
Hi, I'm Kevin from Monroeville, and we have a big mine subsidence hole here called Monroeville. They came out, then they looked at it. By this time, they came out about, I seen it at 11 a.m. They came out around 3. We looked at it, and now you could just see a big hole underneath it really developing. You could hear storm water running through. And then apparently, like, as you see the hole now, there's a big storm drain down there. Then the next day, we had the DEP come out, and they looked at it, and they did some investigation. They found out there's mines underneath here. By that time, the hole was like probably 15 by 20 feet wide and 25 feet deep. And they came out here and they started doing some investigation and they just started rolling with the program. When I heard of mine subsidence, I think it's out in the middle of nowhere in a field where no one can get hurt or no one can do anything, you know, get anything stuck or get hurt. And, I mean, I live in Monroeville. This is a county road. This is the main road. There's a lot of traffic comes through here. This is a school bus route. People walking up and down. And I'm just glad the DEP come out for helping me out, getting this situation under control and handled.
DEP's Bureau of Abandoned Mine Reclamation responds to over 250 reports of mine subsidence each year. One of the most common mine subsidence issues that occur are mine subsidence cave holes. These holes can occur in yards, wooded areas, streets, parking lots, or under homes and other structures. In addition to the obvious impacts to the features on the surface, these subsidence events can also damage underground utilities. When these mine subsidence cave holes threaten the health, safety, or general welfare of the public, PA's AML program addresses them through the AML Emergency Program. Funding to address these emergencies comes from Pennsylvania's annual Abandoned Mine Land Grant, which is derived from fees paid by the active mining industry on each ton of coal mined, and can be used to address abandoned mine hazards caused by mines that were operated and abandoned prior to August 3rd, 1977, when the Federal Surface Mining Control and Reclamation Act became law. Historically, Pennsylvania's AML program has addressed an average of nearly 80 AML emergencies per year, but over the last 5 years, that number has increased to an average of almost 90 AML emergencies per year, at an average annual cost of more than $4.8 million. The AML program is the only program that has funding to address these types of problems, and continued funding of this program is critical to protecting Pennsylvanians from these hazards.
This is Centralia. It's arguably Pennsylvania's most famous ghost town. For 6 decades, it's been in the headlines. There are mine fires all throughout Pennsylvania, they're all throughout the United States, and they're all throughout the world. But without question, the Centralia fire certainly is the most notorious. Having said that, and despite the residents having been moved many years ago, Centralia does still exist. Legally, it's still a borough. And it still provides an important route to neighboring towns. State Route 61, State Route 42, both come through Centralia. And that's a main corridor to Shenandoah, Ashland, Mount Carmel, Aristides, further along to Pottsville. So these hazards here from this mine subsidence still need to be addressed.
One key resource we have is our collection of mine folios. Folios depict the underground mining in the anthracite region. Using the latitude and longitude, we know our subsidence is located on this corner lot of what used to be Main Street Centralia and what is now State Route 61. The surface map shows the Mammoth Vein outcrop east to west, and historically it's showing that this Mammoth Vein has caved in the past.
Our house was right over there. And let's see, it would be about 22 years ago, there was a cave-in right here. And the back part of our house would have disappeared if we were still there, if the house was still there.
On February 14th. 1 week later, on February 21st, we finished our reclamation. In all, 85 triaxles of material of various sizes were used to backfill the void. In anticipation of settlement of our backfill, we've left a mound of material here on the surface. That's done on purpose. So as that material in the ground settles, we've accounted for that here. Pennsylvania has a very interesting, unique, and proud coal mining history, but it comes with a cost. That cost being our abandoned mine hazards. In Pennsylvania, we're fortunate to have funding as well as very talented people to address these hazards. We have engineers, geologists, inspectors, construction workers, equipment operators. We have experts in purchasing and in obtaining materials. So with that talent, we can address these issues. One of the fun things about Pennsylvania abandoned mine land and Pennsylvania coal mining is that we're entrusted to preserve this legacy and heritage, but not only preserve it, oftentimes correct it, and we're able to do that.